Hey, sucker nigga, whoever you are. Hey, sucker nigga, whoever you are. Hey, sucker nigga, hey, sucker nigga, whoever you are. Whoever you are. Hey, sucker nigga, whoever you are. Hey, sucker nigga, whoever you are. Hey, sucker nigga, hey, sucker nigga, whoever you are. Whoever you are. See, for doing all those little stunts I was just doing, look what happened. Just spilled coffee all over myself. 375, 379. I'm telling you, man, it's going down. Everybody be patient. What's up, everybody? It's Monday morning, 8:30 in the morning. It's my day off here chilling at the park. We had a great time last night. My wife's birthday, Easter Sunday. Can't get any better than that, man. We had a good time with the family. The reason why I'm up so early on my day off, because I have to go drop off my son off at his house in Pennsylvania. So it's about a 2-hour ride. He spent the week, spring break, with us. So that was awesome. So we're gonna take him back now. Wife, amazing wife I have. You know, it was her birthday yesterday, so she had a great time. I'll put some clips right now. I didn't record too much yesterday because I really wanted to spend time with them. But I'm gonna show you a couple of clips that I recorded yesterday, right now. It's Sunday, it's Easter Sunday, and this is gonna be a different type of vlog today. I got my son, look at him. He got the same face as I do, big face. And it's not only Easter Sunday, but it's a special day because it is my wife's birthday. You know what I'm saying? She's doing her makeup. Say hello.
Hi.
Oh, now you're being quiet and shy? She wasn't like that a minute ago.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Pursue your happiness. You know, some people were not meant for the road. We left the house a little bit before 10. So yeah, 2 hours to get to PA. We made it. And now we gotta wake up the boy. Well, hello. 2 hours. That's what you call a nap? He told me he was gonna take a 2-hour a nap, and it turns out to be the whole trip.
It's a pretty good nap.
Yeah? Anyway, how was your spring break?
Pretty good.
Now, I'm going to tell, you know, the audience here that how long we've been doing this trip from New Jersey to PA? I'm going to say like 8 years, right? Probably a little longer.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and it still gets longer and longer. It's a long trip. It's a 2-hour trip from New Jersey to PA, here where he lives, and another 2-hour back by myself. Well, it was like driving here by myself because you were sleeping. Anyway, you had a good time?
Yes, I did.
All right, so guys, you know, this is the hard part because I don't get to see him another 2 weeks. Back to school you go?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Anything you want to say?
No.
Say peace. Oh, man. This is the hard part. I hate this part when he leaves. For you guys that see your kids every other week or every 2 weeks, whatever, and you gotta go through this when they say goodbye. It's never goodbye. It's until I see you again. All right, guys, just dropped off my son. It's never easy, you know what I mean? It's never easy to, especially when he spends like a week or a few days with you and then you gotta drop him off again. It's never easy, you know? But just a word of advice. If fathers or mothers, whoever's doing this every other week to see your kids and then drop them home back to their mother or their father, whatever the case may be, it's never an easy situation, you know? I've been doing this, like I said, 8-10 years now. And it just doesn't get any easier, you know what I mean? Especially when they grow up. But word of advice, guys, if you're going through that, I know it's hard sometimes, or some people just don't want to do it. You know what I mean? For those people that don't want to do it, shame on you. You know what I mean? You got to be in your kid's life, no matter what. You and your other half or whatever, if you split up or set aside those differences and just do it for your kid, because at the end of the day, you're not doing it for yourself or you're not doing it for the other partner. This is for your kid, you know what I mean? I know some parents that go through this and their kid lives literally 10 minutes away. 10 minutes! Some even closer, and they don't spend no time with them, you know what I mean? And I know I'm ranting right now, but it just pisses me off, because especially for those people that their kid literally lives 10 minutes away or 20 minutes away, and they say, oh, I'm too busy, I'll pick you up next week, and then next week comes, they still don't pick them up. Shame on you, man. Shame on you. All right, so anyway, see you on the next clip. Oh man, I'm gonna make a quick stop to Arby's and pick up my wife some Arby's, because she loves Arby's. So I'm gonna go pick up some Arby's. The reason being, I gotta pick it up here in PA, in Pennsylvania, is because they don't have it in New Jersey. I mean, they do have it in New Jersey, but we gotta drive a long way. And we used to have a local Arby's, but not no more. Oh, the wife is gonna be a happy camper.
Hi, welcome to Arby's. Go ahead and order whenever you're ready.
All right, guys. Just another topic that came to my head. I was watching a video not too long ago, and it was about this guy that he was taking flowers to his wife for no apparent reason. He just wanted to do it. You know what I mean? And he went to the flower shop, picked up some flowers, and this is where it gets funny. The guy that was selling him the flowers, or the girl, whoever it was, automatically said to him, oh, you must be in the doghouse, right? Wow, man. Really? It's not the best angle, but I just didn't want to be holding the phone while I was driving. It's a long drive back home, and I just thought of something else we could talk about. And that is, not everything is what it seems to be. Again, not everything is what seems to be. What do I mean by that? I know a lot of couples that are boyfriend and girlfriend or in a marriage. And you go to their social media page and it looks like they're having the best time in their life. They're in fancy restaurants, resorts, beaches, you name it. It looks like they're having a blast. But as soon as the camera goes off, or the picture's upload is up already on social media, or the video's up on social media, whatever, the relationship stops. What do I mean by that? When the video's not rolling, or the picture's not being taken, they're in the restaurant or in the hotel room, whatever, just quiet, like a mouse. And the only thing they're talking about is, make sure you send me that picture that we just took so I can post it up. Or send me the video we just took so I can post it up. And then the whole time they're on their phone. Don't say a word to each other privately. Everything's got to be done on social media. So, not everything seems what it is. Now, check this out. Me, I was one of those guys that posted everything on social media. You know what I mean? A picture with my wife and we're having a good time, or a video with her or whatever. But sometimes you just gotta stop and be like, you know what? These are private moments. I don't need to share this with the world. You know what I mean? And I learned that from my wife. She doesn't post a lot of things. She takes a lot of pictures and makes a lot of videos, but she doesn't put anything on social media. A couple of things here and there. Nothing too crazy, but I think I'm the one that does that. But when the video stops and everything's posted on social media, I continue having fun with my wife. We continue doing things. I wish I could put everything so everybody could see. But sometimes you don't have to do that, man. These are private moments that, you know, private memories that you and your wife should have. You know what I mean? So we're almost in Jersey. It's 1:15. We'll probably have another, I don't know, maybe hour drive or so. Alright, so if I think of anything else, I'll let you know. But right now, we're just cruising on by. Cue the music.
We're ready for the road.
My beautiful wife, we made it. It's only 2 o'clock. We made it. Let's see if she likes her present, her food. All right, wait a minute. Come here, girl.
What?
I was telling my viewers that I know you were gonna like your surprise. Did you like your surprise?
Well, my lunch, of course. I always wanted.
Cause there's no damn Arby's here.
No, I love Arby's.
I told you. So we'll see you on the next clip and see what we get ourselves into, right?
See you on the next clip.